Hello, in today's lecture, we focus on the partition coefficient. But what is a partition coefficient? If you are walking in nature, you can enjoy of large lakes where birds are flying and fishes are swimming. And as a result of the presence of oxygen in the water, many sea life is present. In cold areas, more oxygen dissolves in water than in warmer areas. This is illustrated in the following picture, where you can see that the polar areas have more oxygen in their sea surface than the tropics. Although we don't always think about the fact how much oxygen is present in the air and in the water, we know that roughly 20% of the air is oxygen and that about 8 milligrams of oxygen dissolves in 1 liter of water. The ratio of the concentration in air and the one in water is called the partition or distribution coefficient M, between air and water. It describes how a certain component is distributed over the two phases, in this case the value of M for oxygen in the air and water is about 30. This means that there is 30 times more oxygen in the air than in the water. In chemistry labs you often see that a component is extracted from an aqueous phase to an hydrocarbon or vice versa. Generally this is done in the laboratory by a separation funnel or in an industrial environment by an extraction column. Look at this separation funnel. In first instance both phases are well mixed, but if you wait some time no changes occur anymore and you see that the red substance has a greater solubility in the lower layer than in the upper layer. In this way we can remove undesired components from liquids or gases, but it also makes use of it. If you have butter in your mouth, the salt present in the butter will dissolve better in the water phase and you will taste this immediately. So also in this case, as soon as we have two immiscible phases, here the butter and the water phase, a component prefers the water phase instead of the butter phase. Let's look at this sketch. We define the partition coefficient M here by the concentration of the component in the upper phase divided by the lower phase. In this sketch you can distinguish three situations. The green particles prefer the upper phase and M is larger than 1. The purple particles are equally distributed and M is equal to 1. And the red particles prefer the lower phase and M is smaller than 1. So the value indicates the distribution of a certain component over the phases. But we could raise the question, why is the concentration not the same, just like with an interfacial temperature? So if we have two materials with a different temperature, say your finger and a hot plate, and if they contact each other, we have immediately a contact temperature TC between the finger phase and the plate phase. We have seen that this is quite different with two phases where a different concentration of a component is present. To understand why there is a distribution of components at the interface, we have to look what chemical thermodynamics say about this. Let's consider the situation of the red particles in our sketch. From a thermodynamics, we know that if there is an equilibrium between the two phases, we can say that the thermodynamic potential mu of a certain component in both phases is equal. Further, it is known that the chemical potential mu can be written as a function of the concentration, leading to the following relationship for the ratio of the concentrations in both phases. The distribution occurs if the chemical potential of the pure components, the mu zero in this equation, is different in both cases, which is generally the case. In contrary to thermodynamics, where we generally look at systems in equilibrium, transport phenomena deal with non-equilibrium systems. This means that there is always a driving force, like a difference in concentration, temperature, or a pressure difference, and always there is a movement of fluids or gases in the system. The question is, what is the driving force if we contact the two liquid phases to each other with a concentration difference x? Let's consider two systems. One in which we contact the same liquid 1 with different concentrations of component X in both phases, and one in which we consider two immiscible fluids, 1 and 2, each with a different concentration of component X. In the first system, component X dissolves in the same fluid, so the driving force will be the concentration difference. And at the interface, the concentrations are equal. In practice, there is no interface because the phases are composed of the same molecules. In the second situation, there is an interface, and the component X will be distributed over both phases. You see that at the interface, there's a jump in concentration. Generally, we assume that at the interface, the two phases are in equilibrium. But at a certain distance from the interface, component X does not see the other phase. However, there is a concentration difference of the component X in the bulk of each phase leading to transport to the interface. And from the interface, after a long time, both phases are in equilibrium and there is no driving force anymore. This means the thermodynamic potential mu in both phases is equal and the concentration of X in both phases is distributed according to the value of the partition coefficient m. So if we want to remove a certain component from, for example, a hydrocarbon component present in the gas phase with the liquid phase, we have to consider those situations where there is always a driving force in the form of a concentration difference. Each day, chemists in laboratories and in industry apply the concept of the partition coefficient to separate components or to extract them from a certain phase. If you see gas bubbles in your soft drink, you could wonder how the gas is distributed over the gas and the liquid phase and what the distribution coefficient would be. Have a lot of fun in finding examples, and thanks for looking at this video.